If you're looking for the fastest way to get your product information into Shopify and then easily keep it up to date, then you're in the right place. In this video, I'm gonna show you what I consider is the most efficient way to deal with importing and bulk updating product data on Shopify, and as a result, make your whole selling process way faster. And stay tuned to the end because I'll show you exactly what that looks like in real time. When it comes to getting your data into Shopify, there are three options. Option one, entering it yourself manually, product by product, data point by data point. Shockingly enough, that's pretty much the slowest option. Option two, and you might remember this from a previous video, completing a CSV template with your data and using that to upload everything at once. Now, this is definitely a faster option than entering data points one by one, but it does still involve having to deal with a pretty technical CSV template that you then have to manually copy over to Shopify every time you want to add or update products to your store. So it's still not ideal. Then we have option three, which is what I want to show you in this video, using Plytix's direct integration with Shopify. Plytix is a product information management software, and it's a really convenient way to get everything related to your products in one place. So not just product details and specifications, but also stuff like your product images, videos, documents, and so on. It's then got a whole bunch of other features that help manage that product information in a really efficient way. Stuff like bulk editing functions to update all of your products at once, or custom user roles and settings that mean different people can work on the data at the same time, but without getting in each other's ways. You can use it to send data out to everywhere else that you're selling, not just Shopify. And you can even use it to set up workflows and automated checks to make sure that you don't send incomplete information to your Shopify store or to anywhere else. First things first, if you want to use this system, you'll need to get your data and your digital assets into Plytix. Now, there are various ways to do that depending on your current setup, including if you're currently using Shopify as the main place to store your data. You can check out the description of this video for more information on exactly how to do that. Anyway, you can see that when I go into my account, I get an immediate overview of all of my data and assets. And then if I head over to the channels page, you'll see a familiar logo. This is where you can set up the direct integration that I mentioned earlier, which is what lets you connect Plytix to your Shopify store directly, and you can start using all of those handy features. Mine's already connected though, so I'm gonna dive in and show you how I use this to organize and automate the product information and assets that I want to send to Shopify. Here you can choose the list of products you want to work with and include in your Shopify store. You can have as many of these lists as you like for as many different purposes as you'd like. I personally have my Shopify one set up based on an automatic filter that only includes products that are totally ready for Shopify and have all the necessary information added to them. Next, we've got the mapping function. This is how you can match the information that you have in your Plytix account to the relevant fields in Shopify. You can see I've got a few already linked, but let's say I want to link the Shopify field title. All I have to do is select the relevant attribute in Plytix like this, and it'll link the values of that attribute to the title field in Shopify for the products that I'm sending over. This is great because it means that I can store my information in Plytix in whatever way I like, naming my different attributes in a way that makes sense to me personally, but then I can send them over to Shopify in a way that their system can understand without having to either edit my original data or have multiple copies of everything. Plytix gives you a lot of control. You can do stuff like choosing a particular category path to use, which is really useful when you've got products that are in multiple categories. And as you might know, different platforms have you set up categories in different ways. You can change images, names, and dimensions for Shopify without actually editing or copying your original versions, which is great for getting your product pages to look exactly how they should without having to have duplicate versions of your images. You can also handle meta fields here, which as you know, are the custom attributes in Shopify. Just like with the mapping function, Plytix can pull information from whatever attribute you like and use it for a meta field in Shopify without having to edit the original data or assets in your PIM tool. One of the most useful features though is that you can schedule automatic updates here on a monthly, weekly, or even daily basis, depending on how often you update your product information. This is a huge time saver since otherwise, every time something about my product changed, somebody would either have to do a manual CSV upload in Shopify, or worse yet, go and edit the data directly on there. And let's hope that person never got sick, quit, or simply forgot to push the update through. On that note, you've also got detailed process logs here where you can quickly see your previous updates, whether they're automated or manual. It's a useful way to keep an eye on who's done what and when, which gets more and more important as your team grows in size, and it means that you can quickly see if there have been any errors in the upload as well. All right, now that you've seen all of the cool things that this integration does, let's see how it works in real time. I'm gonna show you what it looks like when you import products for the first time, so when you create products in Shopify, and then I'll show you what updating those products would look like afterwards. So right now, I'm going to import the products that I have in the list, new products, and as you can see, my Shopify store doesn't have these products yet. Now, this is important for new products. The handle field shouldn't have any values, but I do still need to link it to a corresponding attribute in Plytix. Now, this is because Shopify is going to automatically create a handle for each new product, which the Plytix integration will then pull back and add to my account. That way, both systems will be able to identify those products later on whenever we want to update them. All right, so basically, once the fields I want to import into Shopify are matched and I've chosen my list of products, all I need to do is click Process Now. And if we refresh our Shopify page here, you'll see that the products now appear in my Shopify backend and in my live store. Now, let's say that my supplier changed prices on me, so now I need to increase the prices for some of these products. If I change them in my Plytix account, then I don't really need to do much else. If I want my store to update, let's say at the end of every day, I can set a schedule here. Or if I want it updated immediately, I can click on Process Now. Now, let's refresh my Shopify store. There it is, all my new prices. On a side note, if I've got Plytix connected to any other place where I'm selling, then those new prices will appear there as well, just as soon as the next update goes through on each of those channels. And all from just changing prices once here in Plytix. So there you have it, a super quick way to upload all of your product information, images, videos, everything to Shopify. If you want more information, you can download our free ebook that compares different PIM options for Shopify users and explains how to use PIM to overcome the technical challenges in Shopify. Or to try the software for yourself, there's a link in the description where you can request your free account. Thanks for watching and see you next time.